Everybody good?
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus. Jesus! 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 Jesus!
Hey. Keep your head down. Look at me. You're gonna be okay.
Where's he from?
13th, skirt.
I thought the Black Watch were up around Hill 60 or somewhere. What the hell's he doing here?
Must have lost his head.
Must have lost his head. In there, Sarge?
Yeah, they would seem to be.
Who the hell would put a gun nest in a church?
Up around Wipers, they put one in a bar. Think about that.
All right, listen up. Highway, you and Skinner, you work your way up that side. Peters, you come with me. We cover, we lead. Everybody ready? Okay. Let's go.
You're gonna be fine, Skinner. Give me a dressing.
Okay.
Oh,
Jesus.
Okay.
Hey, down! Get your head down!
Well, I'm away from the foothills.
This is kind of funny.
For God's sake, Skinner!
Mama! Mama!
You're gonna be okay. We'll get you out of here.
Paul, two sheets.
Leave your rifle. Get in behind me.
I'm going home.
What the hell are you doing?
Halt!
I'm going
Get your
home.
Hands up.
Let us stay.
No, wait. He's not doing anything. He's just clearing
he's
his path.
Let's divano. Hand home.
No, wait. Wait. Camarade.
I'm going home.
No!
Camarade?
It's all right now. You're all right now, Sergeant. You're back home. You're safe.
know they have these birds of prey over there? They call them kestrels. And every time I look at you, it's like I've got one banging around right in here.
You're a patient, Sergeant. It's a common feeling.
Not to me, it isn't. I don't even know your first name.
I'm not allowed to tell you that.
No.
We should go back to sleep.
I don't sleep.
Then how can you have these nightmares?
I don't know.
Good night, Sergeant.
Good night, Kestrel.
Take this opportunity to underscore the elusive relationship between desire and social order.
You're crazy, aren't you?
Crazy for you.
Hello there, Mr. Harper. Hello?
We're in here.
David?
Mr. McKinnon?
You didn't show up for work this morning. That's the third time this month. Sarah here tells me you had an attack. One of your asthma things.
That's the truth, sir, I did.
But now you're all right.
I went down to the river. Sometimes the humidity helps.
Humidity. Good one. That's good. I don't know how to put this, but this job, I know it's only a local newspaper, and I know it's not going to change the outcome of the war or anything. But it's a good job, and your father... Well, you both understand that I'm doing this for your father, don't you? Well, I'll just see myself out. I expect to see you in the morning.
I can't keep lying for you.
I'm not asking you to.
Were you with Cassie?
What if I was?
Friends don't get friends in trouble, David.
What would you know about friends? All you've got is me, and you don't even like me.
Why do you talk like that?
And if there's anyone that doesn't like you, it's you.
Not me.
Is that supposed to pass for insight? By the way, her dad hates me too.
Still no news?
Still missing in action. It's not easy, I can tell you that much. But I'm the mayor. I can't be seen to falter. And our son has a good head and a shoulder, so we remain hopeful.
Are you crazy?
I'm here to talk to your father.
Oh, hello. This is your friend. David, isn't it?
Yes, sir. I wonder if I could have a word with you.
Well, by all means, come on in.
No, sir. I don't want to intrude.
Don't be silly. Come on. Hello, everybody. I'd like to introduce you to David... Oh, good Lord, I've forgotten your last name.
It's Mann, sir.
David Mann.
Very honored to meet you.
It appears that young David has conceived of a passion for my daughter.
Daddy, please.
A passion, is it? Well, then I'd be guessing you'd still be a student.
And you'd be wide on the mark. David here counts himself among the ranks of the working men.
I work for a newspaper.
But he's not a scribe. He sets type. He's a typesetter.
Philip.
But you must be 18 years old and you're not in uniform. Why is that?
It's a medical thing, sir. He's doing what he can.
Yes, well, he'll have to do better than that if he wants to earn the respect of your father.
That's what I intend to do, sir. And I'm open to suggestions.
For God's sake, son, we're at war. Use your imagination.
I'm sorry. I don't know. I'm not sure what I'm supposed to say.
No, there's no formula here, Sergeant. We're just talking. You, want to tell me about your nightmares? They consistently feature the image of a Canadian soldier on a cross. Why is that, you imagine?
I don't sleep, so I don't really know how to answer that.
In 1915, they retreat outside Ypres. German soldiers nailed Canadian NCO to a barn door. You were there, were you not?
Yes, sir, I did take part in that retreat, but... if they had time to stop and nail a guy to a door, they're even better than I already know them to be.
Are you saying it didn't happen?
I'm saying artillery throws soldiers into positions you can't even imagine. A man in a trench, he's gonna see what he needs to see.
Michael, you're a decorated soldier.
Yeah. Yeah, I am. And I received that medal for sticking a 17-inch piece of steel into a boy's forehead.
And as soon as you were well enough to walk, you went AWOL.
I went AWOL because I received a medal for sticking a piece of steel into a boy's forehead.
This is insubordinate.
Understand your situation here, Sergeant. We're trying to determine your status at discharge. Your physical wounds have, for the most part, healed. Dr. Walker would like to give you a clean bill of health, in which case you'd be sent back to the battlefield, stand trial for desertion, and more than likely be executed.
I'm gonna end up back there one way or another.
Michael, I'm trying to save your life.
I know that. And I appreciate it, I do, but this...
Go on.
The house that we grew up in, it was at the bottom of this hill, and every time one of my brothers,
died?
Yeah. The telegraph guy, he'd bring the notification down the hill. My mother never got any other news, so... after all three of my younger brothers, one, two, three, and then me, AWOL. And they don't say absent without leave. They say missing in action, which to her meant I was dead. And so when that telegraph guy came down the fourth time, it broke her heart. She died of a broken heart.
Nurse man, would you please escort the sergeant back to the ward?
Major Nigel Bernard, Canadian Army Medical Corps. Re patient T331, Sergeant Michael Dunn. Physically, the patient needs repair. Diagnosis remains, however, neurasthenia. Dr. Walker's descent noted. In light of his service record, the recommendation is the soldier be reassigned to the home front, possibly recruitment, in support of our ongoing effort.
I came to wish you luck.
It's not likely I'll see you again, is it? I don't want to leave. It's not accurate. I don't want to leave you.
I'm not what you think I am.
You don't know what I think you are.
You talk in your sleep.
I don't sleep. How can I talk?
You don't even know my first name.
No, I don't. No. And that's a hell of a thing, that is. Goodbye, nurse man.
It's Sarah.
What?
Her name is Sarah.
Thanks.
Rigor, Sergeant. Rigor is our shibboleth. No slight intended to my immediate predecessor, but the sails on this ship are slack. Home front is awash in saboteurs and provocateurs. Odd those words sound French, what? Allies and all? Be that as it may, our immediate concern is recruitment. Minimum age, 18. Infantry, service and medical corps. Minimum height, 5'3", chest, 33.5". Gunners, Carmichael, remove this.
Ah, yes, sir.
Capital asset, Carmichael. Gunners, minimum height, 5'7", chest, 34.5". Give or take, you understand. Preference given to unmarried men. The blind and the deaf are to be avoided, and asthmatics are strictly ne touche pas, given the problems associated with gas. And on that note, may I say, in confidence, I have seen acts of depravity done. Kronstadt, human depravity. But gas? Even the Boer would not sink so low.
We use gas, sir.
Of course we do. Cut from the same cloth, you and I. A rarefying experience, combat. Something Carmichael will never encounter. Blind as a bat, feet like a fried egg. Isn't that right, Carmichael?
More than right, sir.
You saw action in South Africa, sir?
I've studied your dossier, Sergeant. But you can rest easy. I have my eye on you. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you a Distinguished Conduct Medal winner, a proud member of Calgary's own 10th Battalion, 2nd Brigade, 1st Canadian Division. Please rise for Sergeant Michael Dunn.
I thought he'd be bigger.
In what sense?
Well, in the sense that he'd be bigger.
Please, please, you're embarrassing the good sergeant. Would all of those women who are present please resume your seats? Thank you. And all those men too old to serve, would you also resume your seats? And all the boys who are not yet of age to serve, would you take your seats as well? And now I ask you to look at the men who stand amongst you. And explain to Sergeant Dunn why they are not doing their part for their king, their country, and their God. Eyes wide open.
Next. Name?
David Mann.
What's your marital status, David?
Single.
And you're of legal age?
Look, I applied before.
Yeah, I see that. And according to this form, you were rejected because you have asthma. Do you now have medical clearance on that asthma?
Well, I wouldn't be here, would I? And this isn't Germany. I don't carry documents with me. You're in uniform. You aren't at the front. Do you have anything to document that?
Matter of fact, I do. They diagnosed me as neurasthenic, which means shell shock, which means I'm mentally incompetent, and this is the paper that proves it.
Haven't you ever heard of patriotism?
Do you have a relative who's a nurse, a sister or something? And you live out on Stewart Avenue?
Maybe.
Okay, as long as I'm sitting at this desk, you will not be going to this war. Next. Name.
How's it feel, war hero?
You only got one arm.
Sad, ain't it? How about we get drunk?
Mikey, 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 forget about the nurse. There's a gaggle of women, all free and clear, ready and willing to hike up their skirts. And you want to know why?
Because you give them money.
No, because I let them know they are in the presence of a real-life war hero.
When did you become a war hero?
When I lost my arm.
You lost your arm in a lumber mill.
Which the ladies don't know, which is what I love about this war.
Joe, got a postcard. From Highway. It seems like the Redskin's back on his feet, and by the sounds of it, he's cutting a swath right through London town.
That's what I hear. Hey, John.
Michael Dunn. Lord God, it's good to see you in one piece.
Well, more or less.
On the house, my friend. Your call.
I'll have whatever you get underneath the cap. I'll be back in a second.
Hey, Royster. To Dunn.
Well, well, well. You two are so Jesusly rhetorical. This man who just left, this man would not allow me to serve. And why? He's been over there. He's run Fritz through with a bayonet.
Johnny, what's this kid doing in here?
Time to go, son.
Do I smell kraut?
You calling me a kraut boy?
Calling me a boy kraut?
I'm just a one-armed man. What are you trying to do here, kid?
Mister, I'm just trying to save my soul.
Let it go, Roy.
What are you, nuts? He would have killed you, you know that?
You come with me.
Thank you for bringing him home.
You don't have to thank me. It's a good excuse to see you again.
Well, thank you anyway.
Okay. Hey. Do you think maybe I could accompany you to a dance, or...
I don't dance with soldiers.
I could lose a uniform.
I don't dance with naked soldiers.
I'm trying to flirt.
I mean, I'm not making it easy, am I?
No. What if I asked your father for permission?
Well, that would be difficult.
He doesn't like suitors.
No, my father's dead, Sergeant. He was killed on Vimy Ridge.
Ah, Jesus. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. Good night.
Good night.
That's harsh. A lot of rum over there, I guess.
Yeah, but they water it down.
Plentiful, though, no?
There's a show on.
Battle, you mean?
Mm-hmm.
Christ. That word's got a ring. It's like... must be like top of the world. Holy shit, these crowds get up to. They crucified one of our guys, for God's sake.
That never happened.
Still?
No, it's a good story. It just never happened.
Still. You know, I follow it. A lot of people, they take it, leave it. But me, every day come 5 o'clock, I got a paper in my hand, nose right to the print. Every step you two take, you and Highway, I'm right there with it. And it ain't just the liquor talking, but I am.
You're what?
Okay, Mikey, I am.
Okay, you're what?
Proud. I'm proud of you. And I'll tell you something else. If I didn't have this stump, I'd be right there between you and Highway on the fire end step. Right in the middle of it. That'd be me.
I know you don't dance with soldiers, but you think maybe you'd go ride with one?
Did you carve this?
No. No, it was Whiskey carved that. I ran a mining camp up near Rocky Mountain House, and the gold ran dry about the same time the war started up, so I figured I'd go sign up and go get killed.
Can I ask you something, Sergeant?
Do you think maybe you could call me, Michael?
Were you at Vimy Ridge?
I did attend that fight, yeah.
What was it like?
It was cold. But we took that ridge and we held it. Nobody else did that. The British couldn't do it. The French couldn't do it. It was just us, the Canadian Corps. You should be proud of your father.
I am.
And it's not common, by the way.
What isn't?
This feeling.
Would you do something for me?
I think I'd do just about anything for you.
Tell me about this. Paint me a picture of it.
I'm not a painter.
Not all that particular.
In this picture, there is a river, and there's a horse, and there's a man sitting that horse. And together, they ford that river. And all these things are in the foothills. And the man rides to a place he thought he knew like the back of his hand. There's something about this day that's different.
Why this day?
There's a woman with him.
Is this woman frightened?
You'd have to ask her.
What about him?
Well, that's the thing. He doesn't have a word for this, for what he feels. And all day long he searches for it, and it's not until he's sitting next to the woman and they're looking over a river he can finally put a name
to
it.
You should stop. In a heartbeat, I could fall so hard. But I'm not. I'm broken somewhere. Quite broken. So I'd start to think you were stupid for loving me. Then I'd begin to resent you, and eventually I would hate you.
Sit here for a bit. You can keep that horse.
The soldier in the modern battlefield is beset with many challenges, most notably artillery. Tissue damage results from shell fragments, which are irregular in shape. Wounds are therefore jagged or, at best, unpredictable. In the soft parts, wounds show deep and extensive attritions and are marked by an extensive effusion of blood and/or serum. Invariably, shell fragments will introduce foreign matter into the wound,
making infection inevitable. Your father wrote this. Jesus.
Pretty scary, eh?
Are you scared?
No. Are you?
No.
Do you want to introduce some foreign matter into me? Why should we wait?
Oh,
wounds are vast erosions, large lesions forming a cul-de-sac. They are abrasions with torn surfaces and quivering and herniated muscles. They are doomed to suppuration and are threatened by grave complications such as gangrene and tetanus. In summary, artillery shells splinter, amputate, decapitate, bisect, quarter, or otherwise grossly mutilate the human frame. In the worst of cases, a direct explosion will obliterate the man. The soldier will simply disappear. Thank you. Sergeant, do you have anything to add to this subject?
No. No, that's pretty much what it does.
So you would agree that artillery represents the greatest challenge to an individual on the battlefield? Sergeant, do you agree?
No, sir. I'm sorry, I don't. The single greatest challenge to an individual on the battlefield is trying to keep his matches dry.
Keep your matches dry. One of the wittier phrases Dr. Walker singles out as having turned his lecture into a farce.
Sir, I didn't mean...
Did I give you permission to speak?
No, sir, you did not.
These are the drawings of your machine?
They are.
You had a diagnosis, did you not?
Yes, sir. Neurasthenia.
And I think we both know what that means. Your draftsmanship is impressive.
You're holding them upside down.
So I am. I'm not saying that you're a coward, Sergeant. I am simply saying that I have been keeping a very close eye on you, and what I see disturbs me.
You'll notice I've left out certain mechanical secrets that can only be revealed upon payment of $1 million.
A lovely round figure. And what exactly will this invention of yours accomplish?
You'll bring the war to an end in 48 hours.
Delightful. And how exactly will it achieve that?
With this machine, an individual can circle the globe in exactly 15 minutes.
Sparkling. We'll be in touch. Thank you. Thank you.
No, I thank you.
Thank you very much.
No, thank you.
The very ground we are standing on is shifting. Civilization hangs in the balance, so I offer a word of warning. Do not plow a foreign field.
Sir, I'm sorry, but I just don't see what this has to do with the dry matches.
For God's sake, man, we are talking about our nation's security, which means we are talking about a certain lady named Sarah Mann, on whose attendance, I am reliably informed, you have been dancing. More specifically, we are talking about her father.
Her father was a soldier who fought on the same ridge I did. The only difference I'm aware of is that he died, and I didn't.
The only difference you're aware of? Carmichael.
Martin Mann was born in Ingolstadt, Bavaria. He returned to his native land in 1915 and was assigned to the 2nd Bavarian Reserve Regiment. He fought for the enemy.
The blood is tainted, Sergeant. Ottawa mandates that we must root out the Hun in sheep's clothing, and root him out we will, like a pig.
With regret, our mandate is uncompromising.
You regret nothing.
I don't expect a woman to comprehend this. But our country is rife with saboteurs.
Oh, for God's sake, when did nursing wounded soldiers become a threat to the homeland? And if I'm so dangerous, why don't you lock me up?
At the moment, internment is not under consideration.
Listen to him. Listen to the sound of his voice. How long has he been living in this country?
My duration of residency is hardly the point.
I've lived here my entire life. I'm a Canadian.
Technically, yes. But here's the sticky wicket. Whereas I was born under the sun of the British Empire, you, Miss Mann, were born under the cloud of Germany.
Oh.
We could move. Start over. Or I could try to find another job.
Doing what?
I don't know. Cleaning, maybe?
Cleaning. This is our home. These are our neighbors.
You can't hate a dead man, David.
And where is that writ, oh sister of mine?
Don't talk like that. You sound ridiculous.
I don't hate our father. He shames me. There's a difference. If I could kill him, I would.
Well, he can only be killed once.
Well, I'm not just gonna sit here.
Where are you going?
Does it matter?
Sarah?
I'm in here.
Where's your brother?
I don't know. He may have gone to Cassie's or maybe our mother's grave. He does that quite often.
Okay, I'll take that horse. I'll go find him. I don't think you should stay here. I want you to go to my place.
Why are you doing this?
Because I fought on the same ridge your father died on. Might have been me that killed him. I mean, I know it probably wasn't, but it might have been. Use that door. It's 213 Stephen Avenue. I'll come find you.
Thank you.
You mind if I have a word with you?
German. Lutz. Dead German.
Mutti. Ich liebe dich.
You can stop that now. Oh, come on, kid. Don't make me chase you.
God damn it.
What's wrong with you?
Why don't you just kill me?
I don't want to kill you. I just want to talk to you.
You should have signed me up.
Oh, God, you want to go to war that badly.
Where do you think I already am? Jesus, look around you. Everything you can see, everything you can imagine, the entire goddamn universe is at war. And if that ever stopped, oh boy, that would be the end of history.
I don't know what you're talking about. All I know is you gotta draw a line somewhere.
And I draw the line at my father.
You think it's that simple?
You don't?
No. No, I don't. Lines are tricky. There's so goddamn many of them. This front line, sap line, behind the line. Lines you don't even know about, lines you can't even see till you cross them. And once you do, you're not fit. You understand? You're not fit for this world. You live over there. You got men underneath you. What the hell am I doing?
Christ didn't die for our sins. He just laid down the template, that's all.
I don't understand you.
If I have my way, you never will. You're looking for romance, kid. You're not gonna find it in the trench. And get up. I'm gonna go find that horse.
Sergeant.
Hi.
Hi.
I found your brother. He's gonna stay with a friend of mine. I'm just on the corner. You can have the bed. It hasn't been slept in.
This could get a little rocky. You saw the morphine.
When I was 23, I robbed a bank in Fort McLeod.
I don't do it every day.
I don't rob banks every day.
After my father left, I had trouble sleeping, and there was this ready supply at the hospital. I can't explain it.
You don't have to.
I've tried everything I can to do my part, but...
But you were frustrated. No, I understand that. And I commend you, son. I commend your selflessness. It would seem my daughter has indeed picked herself a fine young man.
Present this letter to the recruiting officer and your way should be clear. And with that, you have my blessing on your union.
Oh, Daddy. I tore my father in half this war. It just made our lives impossible. So I forced him to make a decision. It was them or us. I really didn't think he'd leave. But I was sending him to be killed. Which seems to be killing my brother. All this. For what?
I killed a kid. I killed a lot of men, but I killed this one kid. And these blue eyes. They were like water. And I didn't have to kill him. I wasn't scared or... I just killed him. I'm gonna have to answer for that. One way or another.
Congratulations, son. You've proven yourself a true patriot.
Excuse me, sir, but I can't imagine Sergeant Dunn rejecting a candidate without cause.
And this form identifies the cause as asthma. Do you have asthma, son?
Not me, sir.
There you have it, fit as a fiddle.
But, sir...
Shut up, Carmichael. In your encounters with Sergeant Dunn, he bore no signs of ill health, did he? And yet he is not in the field. Why is that, do you imagine?
He told me he had neurasthenia.
The military is a curious and beautiful beast. Neurasthenia is our way of saying that Sergeant Dunn is a coward.
I've always thought that way down somewhere it was all about sacrifice. Why, I don't know. Now there's you. If I asked you, would you kiss me?
Ask me.
There's only one rule. Don't die.
What are you doing?
I'm going.
Where?
Where do you think?
Oh God, David, please don't. No, no, I won't have this. You're a boy.
I'm not a boy.
You have asthma.
I'm not a cripple.
I can't let you. David, please, talk to Sergeant Dunn. He'll tell you not to go.
Oh, really?
Yes, he would explain to them and they would let you out.
And what makes you think they'd listen to him? Think he's some kind of hero? Is he missing an arm? A leg? Is he blind? Why isn't he still over there?
I don't know.
He's got neurasthenia. You know what that means in the army? It means the man's a coward.
No. No, he's not.
No, he's not? Who do you think signed me up? He's the reason I'm going to war.
Gentlemen, I'm honored to have you in my home to observe this solemn and hopeful occasion. And I turn it over to you, Major.
Gentlemen, the eastbound train carries our valiant youth on the long road to glory. May God go with them. Yes. To the boys.
To the boys.
To the men.
To the men.
Men.
You raise an army? You rake the very bottom and find the weak, the young, the sick, and you send them? My brother is just a boy. He's not well. He's not fit. Why do you want him? Well, you have nothing to say? Nothing at all? This isn't out of the blue, Sergeant. I'm not out of the blue. I'm right here, right now, and I'm asking you, who will be there to watch over my brother?
Thank you.
You know you can take any one of them. Artillery, gas, wire, rain, rats, fucking bayonet. Not one of these can you control. The matches you can control, you can have some effect upon them. And if you're in the middle of a barrage and you think a smoke might steady you up and you reach for those matches and they're wet, well, sir, your whole world buckles. It feels like it's coming apart at the seams. And that's not farce. That is not farce. I need you to sign this.
McCrae?
It's my mother's maiden name. I'm going back. You're going to assign me to the fighting 10th.
You're going to try and protect that boy. You really are neurasthenic, aren't you?
Cut from the same cloth, you and I.
You know I'll track you down.
Be my guest.
Come in. Oh, hello, Cassie. How can anyone do this?
I don't know.
Why are you packing?
Well, I can't find a job, so I can't afford the upkeep.
I could talk to my father. I mean, you're almost family.
How is that, do you imagine?
You haven't heard from David?
No.
I haven't heard from him either, which is strange considering we're engaged.
You're engaged?
Well, that's the whole reason he joined up. Because my father has his ways and David had to prove himself.
Is that why Dunn signed him up?
You mean that sergeant? God, no. He had nothing to do with it.
I don't understand.
He wasn't going to sign David up come hell or high water. I had to get my father to write this medical thing saying...
So it wasn't Sergeant Dunn?
No. It was the other one. The British one.
Oh, my God.
I'm sorry, I don't...
What have you done?
What do you mean?
Your father doesn't want David to come home. He wants him to stay over there with a white cross to mark his spot for the rest of time.
What are you saying?
Sarah, I'm not sure if you'll get this, and I don't know if I'm all that good at painting these pictures, but I am trying. In this picture, there is a river, and there is a horse, and there is a man sitting that horse, and all these things are in the foothills. And when this man closes his eyes, he can see a woman kissing him as like as to smother him. And this man knows that kings may die and countries may crumble, but that if people look close enough, they just might, as I have, Sarah, they just might find something to believe in.
I have to go now. But before I do, remember that rule. Don't die.
Okay, sound off.
What's in the bag, Lieutenant?
In a minute, sound off.
Highway.
Dale.
Gordon.
Witchell.
Horn.
Miles.
Johnson.
Man.
McCray.
Here we go. Little gift from the CO. Last supper kind of thing. Let's get yourselves together, gentlemen. Get that bird plucked. I need to check in with HQ.
Nice form. Had practice with that?
Just around the house.
You want me to give you a hand with that?
The last goddamn time. I don't need your help.
Hey, MP!
The RSM's with him.
Form up!
McCray!
Private McCray, sir.
Last time I met you, your name is Michael Dunn.
April 22nd, Kitchener's Wood.
820 men went in, 174 came out. Lieutenant Hansen, 2nd Field Artillery, immediate response. We were getting mauled, Major Bingham. Dunn here had a bullet in his thigh, crawled across a field of corpses to get us support. Should have been a VC. Unacceptable. I want yes within an hour. Mr. Watchman.
Sir.
You mind having that conversation with Lieutenant Maxwell? Outside, if you could.
Yes, sir.
Major, you want to step forward? Turns out you falsified some records. Somewhat aggressively, according to Dobson Hughes here, and he wants your head. So, what do I do?
You have to turn him in.
I wasn't asking you, Major. What do I do with you, Dunn?
I suppose he's right, sir.
All right, then, that's what I'll do. But I'm not going to turn you into the military police. I'm going to turn you into a platoon leader. And you will hold your tongue, Major. Maxwell will come back to HQ with us, and Dunn, you're going to take over number 2 platoon. This party we call Passchendaele started 3 months ago, and it's been raining ever since, so the battlefield's like a bowl of stew. And the whole thing stalled. So the job of breaking out falls to the only outfit in this entire circus that seems capable of getting anything done, and that's us, the Canadian Corps. You know, they got a name for us, the enemy. They call us stormtroopers. Major Bingham?
The assault has two thrusts. On the right, brigades from 2nd Division will clear the village of Passchendaele. On the left, the Little Black Devils and the 7th Battalion, with us in support, will attack along the muscle-marked Michio Road. This is the assault front, this is our support line, and this is battalion headquarters. And we have three objectives: Venture Farm, Vindictive Crossroads, and Hill 52. It's where we stop and dig in. There are your battle orders.
You got any questions?
No, sir.
Well, I got one. You were free and clear of this freak show. Why'd you come back?
For love, sir.
That's a sorry bastard reason. Good luck, Don.
With respect, sir, I feel compelled to lodge a formal complaint.
This is no time for personal vendettas, Major. In case you haven't noticed, we're neck deep in hell and Curry's projecting 16,000 casualties. The general's never wrong, so I need soldiers. Now, I'm not sure I count you as one, but I'm gonna keep you close. It might improve your chances.
I bow to your superior judgment, sir.
Not sure what I should say to the men.
You know, sir, I didn't ask for this.
I know. It's funny, though. You come all this way, you got a light.
Need a doctor.
Here. Put him down here, soldier.
What are you doing here?
It's what I'm good at. Where else was I going to go?
Anywhere but here, sir. Jesus.
I volunteered out of Regina.
How?
Royster helped me.
How'd you get here?
It took me a month to catch up to you. It's okay. You'll be fine. No. How's David?
He's okay. He's with me. We're keeping our heads down.
Oh, no. They're gonna make you leave. My shift is over soon.
Okay, Piccadilly, King's Cross. I'll meet you there.
You can go now, soldier.
Are you worried?
Yeah.
Don't be. We're just a support company. We won't even see action.
What about David?
If I could get you to him, I would, but it's not safe past here. But I promise you this, I will bring your brother home.
Look what I made you come back to.
It wasn't you, Sarah. I was gonna end up back here one way or another.
Can you give this to David? And remember the rule.
You're gonna see me again.
Alright, this is it.
This is what?
This is our trench.
Where?
Right here. String out, two to a crater, let's go.
You got any matches?
I gave them all to you.
What?
I gave them all to you.
Yeah, but don't you have, like, a reserve?
Oh, the reserve matches.
Those will do.
Right. Okay. They're wet too, though.
I just don't understand. You can say you don't like Sudbury when you've never even been there.
I don't have to go there. I'm a skin. Skins just know.
Fuck you and the Scorn Horses, you old Enon.
You signed up for?
No, sir. Wrong. I signed up to kill Germans.
No, you didn't. You signed up to kill your father. Hey, I've been carrying this around since Calgary. Your sister wanted me to give it to you.
What the hell is wrong with me? I haven't even written her. My own sister. What if something happened to me? How would I atone for that?
If that's what you're looking for, you've really come to the wrong place.
How can you say that?
Come on, David, look around you. You see any poets in this shit? We're all in a slaughter yard. There isn't a single guy here knows why.
No. No, no, you wouldn't be here if you believed that.
I'm only here because of your sister. Listen to me. Forests burn because they have to. And oceans, they go up and down because they have to. I don't think we're that different. If you want to get through this, you got to start seeing it for what it is. It's something we do all the time because we're good at it. And we're good at it because we're used to it. And we're used to it because we do it all the time. You better hang on to something. The guns are coming.
Everyone synchronized?
Yes, sir.
Our assault starts now.
Forward post reporting. 7th and Devils in no man's land, sir. 50 yards, light resistance.
German counterfire reported, sir.
Give me divisional headquarters. I want to know if they've heard anything further about... Except for make sure the lines are okay. Light! Somebody bring me a light!
We got a real problem.
No matches?
Wait. How's the look, you think? Are we going in?
I don't know. It's too early to tell.
Keep your head down, kid.
Mr. Watchman!
Fire crew!
1 second, sir!
Dobbs and Hughes, you're acting 2IC. Eyes here. Eyes here!
Come here. It's all right, it's all right. You're okay.
Objectives consolidated. Both flanks. Field of fire, 200 yards. Venture and Vindictive have fallen.
So far, so good. So far, so good. So far, so good, yeah?
I'll get you out of here soon.
You're okay. Okay. You're all right.
Flare sighted. SOS. Devil's left flank under counterattack, sir.
Give me 8 battalion.
Lines down, sir.
Something's wrong.
What?
Second flare sighted. Left flank 8.
Third SOS flare sighted. Left flank. The 8th is taking a beating, sir.
Is your company ready?
Yes, sir.
All right, Major, in you go. Give him hell.
There's a runner headed this way.
Yeah, shit.
All right, this is it, boys! We're going in! Check your gear! You don't need this, and you don't need this, and you don't need this coat.
Where are you going?
Don't leave me. Just please don't leave me.
It's okay. I'm right here.
The devil's being hammered, sir. There's a crack in the line.
The mud, the country's quite beautiful, no?
Would you kindly shut up? Hey, is that a hawk?
No, it's a kestrel.
What the hell's a kestrel?
It's a hawk.
We need some relief!
Strung out here. You're 800 with just a company, 60 guys.
You want me to stay? You're gonna have to shoot me.
Beat it.
Where are you going?
HQ, little black devils pulling out. Situation critical. Stress critical.
Are regrouping.
I see them.
They're gonna counterattack.
We don't have enough guns!
Nothing from A Company?
Still down, sir.
British 3rd Brigade is stalled. Fusiliers are being routed. Route them all to hell.
The Black Devils have pulled out. Our flank will be open, sir.
Our whole fucking line will collapse. Follow me. I want to talk to the Devils.
Marker!
Hey.
Thanks.
Bring on the hell.
Here come the guns!
Support company, 60 men. You pulled out a whole fucking battalion?
Jesus.
Sir, 60 men, it's impossible. They'll be overrun, then we'll be overrun. We have to withdraw.
We don't withdraw a fucking inch. We don't give ground, we don't lose an objective, and we don't give up a single gun.
But Colonel, if the enemy breaks through, we'll be in danger.
Lieutenant Hanson, you're acting 2IC. Let's go.
Here we go.
God damn it, the whole battalion!
Sergeant, when do you want this order for, sir?
Now! Every last one of them! Get them in there! Now!
All eyes here! They're piling up out there, so all personnel not immediately engaged, report outside for triage!
Shoot!
Shoot the goddamn rifle!
Was ist denn hier passiert?
Jeez!
Oh. Morphine.
Don't get any fucking relief!
Sarge, here. You need some water.
Anybody got ammunition?
I'm out.
Spit!
Here they come again!
We need some relief!
Damn it!
It's battalion! They're here!
Come the relief!
The whole goddamn battalion's here!
Stretcher bearers! Both these men!
Battalion's in line, sir, and the line is holding. Objectives are secure.
Aid post reporting still more wounded en route, so let's make room for them. We did it, by the way. We took Passchendaele. I need an assessment over there.
He's okay. David's okay.
Look at you.
Yeah. Look at me, all broken up like this.
I think maybe you're forgetting the rule.
No, I'm just trying to finish that picture, but I don't think I'm all that good at these pictures, so maybe this man could just write to her.
And will he?
Yes, sir, he will. He'll sit at this little table, and what he'll write is that in this picture, there is a river. And there is a horse. And there is a man sitting that horse. And together they ford that river.
And all these things are in the foothill. I think you're forgetting the rule.
No. No, I'm gonna cross that river.
Michael.
After the guns are silent, after your wounds have healed, after those crosses been planted in all those fields, after that long boat ride all the way across the sea, and after train carries thee. I will love you after the war. I love you for always, forevermore. I will love you after the war, forever, for always and more. After your boots dry and the tobacco's all but gone, along with all those postcards you've carried under your arm, after this blackbird lifts up from off your chest, and after your soul takes its final rest, my love, I forgive you. You never planned to die, and love, I'll place to